Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah. Ella was a young lady. Her dad is Lord Tremien, very successful businessman, has a huge house, has a wife and this girl. Unfortunately, his wife died and Ella became an orphan. To raise her up, he thought to marry again, and he did. And unfortunately, the stepmother, Lady Tremaine, had conflict of interest. She had two daughters of her own. And she looked after the interest of her own daughters. And she neglected Ella. And she abused Ella. She made her a servant at the house under her disposal, and the two daughters. They became very cruel to her. They became very ugly in their treatment to her. They asked her to sleep in the kitchen next to the fireplace, which she cleaned regularly. And that snug or that ash or that cinder covered her face and her clothes. And ever since, she's been known with the name Cinderella. Cinderella. The most beautiful girl. The stepmother, Lady Tremaine, and the two daughters, Drizella and Anastasia. This is when she was very cruel to Cinderella. What made Cinderella beautiful, and what made these two girls not beautiful? It's not the way they were created, because all of them were beautiful in the standards we know of beauty pageant and so on. But what made Cinderella a beautiful girl is her character, her good character, her calmness. With all what happened to her, never complained, never screamed, never was whining. She was very peaceful. Even the birds come to her, and the mice. She was very serene. She was patient. She controlled her anger, and she has all the right to be angry, but she disciplined her anger. She all along was kind, gentle. She was non-violent and peace-loving. That's how Cinderella became beautiful. And that's how she managed to do well during these difficult times. And that's how the outcome of all this behavior made her Princess Cinderella. All of you remember the poetry I told you my mom used to tell me about the true beauty, that it is not your clothes or you were, how you were created. It's your character. ليس الجمال بمئزر فعلم وإن رديت بردا إن الجمال معادن ومناقب أورثن حمدا. So the true beauty lies in your behavior, your moral values, your character, and how much of them you apply to yourself. And Islam, all of it is about moral values. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. It's moral values. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very peaceful, very kind, very gentle. And he told him and us, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَظًّا غَلِيظَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْفَضُّوا مِنْ حَوْلِكَ. Quran is here to teach us to be kind and gentle and peaceful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to talk across the board to everyone, humans and animals, in a kind, nice way. وَقُولُوا لِلنَّاسِ حُسْنًا. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praised one of his companions with the name Al-Ashaj Al-Asri. And he told him, you have two characteristics God loves so much. And he asked him, what are they? He said, Al-Hilmu Wal-Anat, Peaceability. And we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the worst of humans, epitome of evil, Fir'aun. He made himself God, and he asked people to worship him. And when Allah instructed Musa alayhi salam and his brother Harun to go there and advise him, he told them, don't be ugly to him. Be nice and kind. اذهبا إلى فرعون إنه طغى فقولا له قولا لينا لعله يتذكر أو يخشى. And all of us, the worst among us is less than Fir'aun. So that advice applies to all of us, to talk nice to everyone. Muslim never angry, or they discipline their anger. They do not become emotional, and he's easygoing, simple, kind, gentle. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described the believers to us and told us, Al-mu'minun, hayyinun, layyinun, Muslims, kind, gentle, easygoing. Kal-jamal al-anif in qidan qad wa in unikha ala sahratin istanakh. So he is so like Plato, you know, like gentle, like, you know, very easygoing. So we need to learn this lesson. And don't forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to build that character of peaceability. He told us, وَخْفُضْ مِنْ صَوْتِكَ. Lower your voice, lower your volume. He told us, وَلَا تَمْشِ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَرَحًا. Do not be arrogant, show off, rude. And he told us that the mu'mins, the believers, they are very peaceful, they walk very gently. أَلَّذِينَ يَمْشُونَ عَلَى الْأَرْضِ هَوْنًا. They walk very gentle, calm, and quiet way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, when somebody is ugly to you, you be kind to him. And if he is very, very ugly, you walk away. You don't confront him, you don't fight with him. وَإِذَا خَاطَبَهُمُ الْجَاهِلُونَ قَالُوا سَلَامًا. Peace. goodbye. I'm not interested in fighting. I am a very peaceful person. This is Islam, which one of the meaning of Islam is peace. Surrender to the will of God and the commandments of God and the orders of God. So this is my message to you today, to be like Cinderella, kind, gentle, peaceful. Do not whine, do not scream, do not fight. Be kind to each other. Siblings, be kind to each other. Friends, be kind to each other. Be kind to your neighbors. Be kind in your society. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.